Tempest is such a kind of drama where we have the beauty of storytelling. Normally, storytelling is related to short stories, novels, or those fictions. But in this particular drama, we have that very essence, that very beauty of storytelling. By whom? By Prospero. The story of his past is strong enough, is too strong that even Miranda accepted. Your story is so powerful that can infuse the listening power inside the deeps. The Tempest does not start with a calm and serene atmosphere. It starts with a kind of calamity, starts with a climax. That's the most important feature in this drama. It starts with a climax. What's the climax? That the ship being destroyed with the magical powers of Prospero, intentionally done to teach them a lesson. And why has he done that? Constitutes the story of this entire drama. We have completed a huge part in this act 1 scene 2. Almost 230 lines we have completed. This scene is a large one. And this is a part of comedy, of having huge scenes. Tragedies basically do not have so large a theme, but comedies do have that. And the process of his storytelling, of Prospero's storytelling, is very important in this drama, since we may have plenty of questions from here. The entire past, entire background is reflected here. The plot is fast moving. Though it is having plenty of lines, the plot is extremely fast moving. Why I am saying so? Because nowhere will be feeling boring with Prospero's speech regarding his past. So it's in our hand how we are going to perceive this particular scene. Thinking that the scene too long will not help you. So it's my suggestion, think that the plot is extremely fast, the story is being told in a very simple and lucid format, and more than that, it constitutes half of the drama. Past is essential in everyone's life, and often the past is so powerful that it covers and disturbs the present, and the future is depending on that. So the past of Prospero is so powerful that it covers half of his present and will constitute or format his future. So here we go, we'll go through the detail of this particular scene. Having doubt, kindly let me know. So here we go, so the spot. I find my zenith does depend upon the most auspicious star. Here my prescience means ability to see the future. So my prescience means the ability of seeing future of Prospero. What he can see in his future, that he see that his zenith does depend upon a most auspicious star. Zenith stands for here fortune, or the perfect fortune that depends upon what? The most auspicious star. That means a lucky star, the luckiest star. It is believed that the stars control somewhat our life. And here Prospero's future and fortune depends on a particular star, whose influence, whose influence, if I do not value the influence of that star, if I fail to value the influence, or if I undervalue the star, and I omit that very start, then my fortune will ever droop. Then obviously the fortune will fall. Here sees more caution, and here should not be any more caution. So he just says that his fortune depends upon the star, the luck, and it is necessary for him to perform the trick and sink that very ship of his enemies. If he did not do so, his fortune would surely fall. So it was necessary for him to do so. Next, and further, if we look at that, it was the perfect time for Prospero to take revenge on his enemy. If he lost that particular option, then obviously he would not be able to rise up again. This was the perfect timing. His luck also helped him, and he made full use of that. He sunk the ship. Thou art inclined to sleep. That means you are almost going to sleep. Miranda was about to sleep. It is good dullness. You are just looking like hazy, or you are feeling hazy, and give it away. So kindly sleep. I know you cannot choose. That means you cannot help but sleep. There is no option left to him but sleep. So you must sleep. So almost the story of Prospero is done. And more than that, we are also told the story of his life. Come away, servant, come. Her servant stands for Caliban and Ariel. I am ready now. Approach, my Ariel, come. Enter Ariel. All hell, master, great master, grips a hell. That means my worthy and most respected master. Hell to you. That means my fullest respect goes to you. So, here, all hell, great master, grip sir, hell I come. So, most respected master, all my devotion, all my wealth, worth and value and strength dedicated to you, I come to answer you best pleasure. Answer you means here to serve you with blessed of my pleasure. So Ariel is ready to serve his master and give him the best pleasure. Bid to fly, to swim, to dive into the fire, to ride on the curled clouds. That means at the order of his master, he is ready to do anything. He is ready to fly, he is ready to swim, he is ready to dive into the fire, he is ready to ride on the curled clouds. To thy strong bidding task, to your strong bidding task, Ariel and all his quality. So here, bidding means ordered. So any task, any order that is going to be given by Prospero to be followed faithfully by Ariel. With all his quality and all his strength, he is follow his master's order.